Press A to select everything, then X to delete. Hold Shift and press A to add in a cylinder. Tab into edit mode and press S followed by Z to scale the cylinder in the Z direction. Alt select the top edge loop, press E, then S to extrude and scale. Press G then Z to grab and lift the edge. Then press E followed by Z to extrude up the neck of the bottle. Now, Alt select the bottom edge loop, hold down Control and press B to bevel the edge. Use the scroll wheel to adjust the number of segments. Repeat this for the rest of the sharp edges. The lip of the bottle does not need to be beveled since the lid will cover it. Tab out of edit mode and add in a solidify modifier. In X-ray view, the thickness of the bottle can then be seen. Adjust until satisfied. Once happy, make sure to apply the modifier as seen here. Deactivate X-ray view, right-click on the selected bottle and select Shade Smooth. Now press Shift and A to add in a cylinder for the cap. Tab into edit mode, press S to scale it down, then S and Z to scale it in only the Z direction, then G and Z to adjust its position. The exact scale and position is up to you. Alt select the top edge, hold Control and press B to round out the edge slightly. Repeat this for the bottom edge. Press like on this video and select subscribe to learn more Blender tricks. Once you've done that, tab out of edit mode, right-click on the lid and select Shade Smooth. Now, in the shading window, add in a new material for both the lid and bottle. Delete the principled BSDF for the glass bottle and replace it with a glass BSDF. Adjust the color until satisfied. You can also play around with the roughness and index of refraction, but I just left them as default. For the lid, adjust the color to a nice silver and increase the metallic slider to 1. Also reduce the roughness to give it some shine, but not too much that it becomes a mirror. Now, here's a trick to add a label to your bottles easily. Add in another cylinder, tab into edit mode, scale it up, but make sure that it is the correct height for the label. Then, select the top face and delete it. Also delete the bottom face. Tab out of edit mode and add in a shrink wrap modifier. Select the bottle as the target. This should cause the label to stick to the glass. However, it is a bit too tight and seems to be glitching. To solve this issue, add in a solidify modifier to the label to give it some thickness. Don't make the label too thick though. Right-click and select Shade Smooth. Add in a new material for the label and connect an image texture node to the base color input. Load in your label image. It probably is not scaled correctly. To fix this, go into the UV editing window. Press A to select the entire label, then hover over the left-hand side of the screen and press A again to select the lines. Press S followed by X or Y to scale the label to fit the image. Once the image and label line up, go back to the shading window. Now, everything should look correct. The bottle is complete. I will quickly go over my process for creating a backdrop and adding in the camera. Shift A to add in a plane, tab into edit mode, and scale it up. Move it down so that it aligns with the base of the bottle. Select the back edge, press E, then Z to extrude it up. Bevel the back corner. Tab out of edit mode, right-click and select Shade Smooth. Under the World menu, click the yellow dot next to color and add in an environment texture. Load in an HDRI. These can be found for free on websites like Polyhaven. Go into the render view to view the HDRI. Shift A and add in a camera. Adjust its location. By placing the camera further back, the focal length can be increased to decrease the lens angle and improve the framing. This can be done in the camera menu. Once everything is adjusted and the framing is good, go into the render menu. Switch from EV to cycles. This can be tough for some computers, so by holding Control and pressing B, it is possible to drag a window over the camera so that only the image in the camera's view will be rendered. Now, to increase render time, increase the noise threshold to 1. This does decrease quality slightly, but not much. Also, reduce the number of samples to around 300. Finally, in the upper left corner, click Render, then Render Image. And wait! Congratulations! You just completed the bottle. Hope you found this helpful, and until next time, keep designing.